for over 500 million years, insect brains swimming, jumping, and flying in prosperity. I wonder why they are so successful for such a long time. There could be many distinguishing factors coming into play, but one of the most important factors is the wing. Over several decades, many biologists and engineers have been studying these various insect wings. For example, on how the wing pattern evolved. What kind of processes regulate the formation of wings? How they flap their wings? What kind of forces they can generate? The latter two topics are meant to provide some insight for developing flying micro-robots, which could be extremely helpful at the site of disaster. Now, we need some breakthrough to have them at hand. But what will it be? As I said, there are many works devoted to the wing, but unfortunately, most of them are categorized in separate disciplines, biology and engineering. There is a huge gap between them. Let us imagine if we use the knowledge of how they are created and understand how they work. Then we can create something new. To understand the relationship between the biological knowledge and aerodynamic functions, we pick up one insect with almost flight perfect skill. That is the dragonfly. So now we are doing research on the interplay of these aspects of dragonflies. We analyze individual variation patterns in dragonfly wing patterns and analyze how changes the wing pattern change the body behavior. Here are 24 wings superimposed. You can see similar pattern in the top right area and variation in the bottom left. And in particular, this vein is conserved. So we doing vortex behavior. So we doing research on cutting off this vein. And cutting off this vein and look at vortex behavior before and after. So, and vortex behavior drastically changed. So, we plan to find what factors change the vortex behavior and how other vein pattern influence wind and the wing. So, thank you for listening. Sorry.